Well, hello everyone, and welcome to a Let's Play of Wars Across the World. I did a Let's Try on this, and I enjoyed the game a fair amount. And I figured I could do a Let's Play of it. The game has been updated once. In my Let's Try, I mentioned that Hastings didn't work, so this is fixed now, for what I understand. So we can play a game on Hastings. The difficulty level, as far as I understand it, is chosen here in the options. It's the AI level. This basic, volunteer, and expert. I'm gonna go for expert. I think I'm going to regret this terribly, but we'll try. I don't know if the AI gets bony on the AI level, or if this really is just its brain that I'm handicapping with this, but I wanna see how good this AI gets when we put it to the test. It does say the Saxons are the most difficult, because they own England, and I mean, the Normans won in reality, so how about we go the middle way and we go for the Vikings? Also, because it's written on the very left, I'm assuming this is what you're meant to play. I should note, I haven't played this, this campaign yet, because as I said in the last try, it was broken. This is it's only now been activated. I did play the first turn before, because that was possible, because it was only during the enemy movement that the movement wasn't possible. So I kind of know how we start, and that is, I know we have two ships here, and those two both have armies on it. And I think one of the ships had an army with 8 people on it, and the other ship had an army with 4 or 3 people on it. One of the two. And I think both had leaders, which are needed to attack. I'm not entirely sure which one is which or how I want to land here. My idea, my plan behind the whole thing is, I'm gonna land my units. Then I will take one of the ships and leave it here, just to shuffle over additional units, because I can only produce units in Norway, right? And the Normans can only produce units in France, and the Saxons can only produce units in England. But that's not a problem, because the battle's going to be in England. So I want to use my second ship to try and cut off Norman supply routes, and just not supply routes, because this, I don't think there's supply here, but I want to go down here and stop the Normans from reinforcing whatever they shuffle to England. And the other ship is going to be transporting my reinforcements to England. That way, I hope to keep the Normans kind of out of the fight. So I think this is my 8-unit army and this is my 3-unit army. I kind of want to keep them together, so I'm going to land both of them in the north. Yes, let's do that. So let's start. It's been too long into the game without me doing anything. For purchases, we do have 4 gold, so I'm just going to take 2 units. Since I need to move all my units to the sea, and all of them only touch the Norwegian Sea, it doesn't matter if I produce where I produce them. At least that's what I believe is the case. I will move this one down here, because it doesn't matter, actually. Yeah, kind of doesn't matter. This is the big armor, right? Yeah. Let's do it like this. And go like this. I will initiate a battle here. The enemy, the Saxons, have 2 huge armies. They have their king here, and they have, and not big, but a decent army here in York. So we'll land here. I will try with him to take York, and I'm going to assume I'll try to destroy the north, and I'm going to assume that William sets over, and I hope that those two bash their heads in. And That would be awesome. If he walks up, I will try to engage him with my bigger army. So let's land on the shores of England. It's only one unit. I can play the coastal raid. Yes, I can. I think I want to hold on to this and use it for a bigger battle. I'm actually not sure if you get more victory points the bigger the battle is, but I'm just going to assume that. So I'm going to hold on to it. Come on, give me some. Yeah, we're making him flee. The good thing about making him flee is he can't hurt us either, because the fleeing always happens before the killing. So if I make him flee, even if he had gotten a green number, he would have fled first. I'd still have preferred to kill him because he now joined the garrison in York, making it more dangerous. So the Normans get their second card. Let's see what they do. They get 7. I got 4 gold, so they get almost twice my money. Okay, they can now... Wait, I'm an idiot. Excuse me. That wasn't the Normans, that was the Saxons who get twice the money from me. So I really need to hurry up and get the killing going, because... they are going to be outproducing me quite heftily here. Okay. They go... The Normans really go big on the whole cult draw. Okay. They get even more units. And they get even more units. Oh my goodness. I think I should have played the Normans. Okay. Viking furrow. So basically I do more damage. That sounds like something I'd enjoy. I'm gonna do what I said before. So I will move this unit up so I can move the units in and get them to the north next time. And this one I'm going to move down to La Manche. And excuse me if I just completely butchered that French name, but I think that's how you pronounce it. Feel free to correct me. I cannot support the attack now with this unit. I would really like to, and I don't see why I can't, but I can't. So I'm going to use it to murder this guy up here. We're first gonna do York, because this will decide whether we need to start crying. Do I play the Viking Furrow for this? I think they all get minus one attack because I have 2 morale more. I think how the morale penalty works is 1 morale difference isn't a problem. But every point above that makes -1 to their strength. So if he had has four and he has 2, they get -1. And I think if he had 1, they'd get -2. I think that's how it works. We'll find out soon. So those are all 1s, and I have 4s, I have 2s, and I can't see my units in the south, but I think they're 3. So I think we'll be fine. I think I'm gonna keep the Viking for all for when we fight the king. I keep so much for when we fight the king. I bet when we fight the king, I will have discarded 50 cards already, because I kept everything from. Okay, he makes 1 of me flee. I get to... Why didn't I get to choose that? But 1 fled, 2 were murdered. So let's try it again. Okay, the side was not... Oh, I could have rooted them. I don't want to root him, I want to murder him, but probably I'll get at least 1 yellow and he'll flee anyway. No, he didn't, so I'm killing him. That's brutal, but it's better for me. Why do I need a root test? He doesn't have units anymore. Yeah, I rooted him now. Oh, we got the leader. Oh no, Morka safe. Was there a second leader? I'm assuming there was a second leader then. So this is the battle in the south No, in the very north. I think it's the most northern province. So here we won't get a morale thingy. I think I'm just gonna win this by numbers. I don't want to waste the furore for it. Because it's just one unit. And we do get a tactical bonus. Because we have a leader and they don't? Is that it? I'm not 100% certain of all the rules, but I think that's how it goes. So now we're trying to siege York. We need to get something under a 7. That should be doable. Yeah, we won. We've got York. So, let's end this turn. The Saxon King is moving up. And so we will, yeah, he's south of our king, so we'll engage him next turn. We can engage him here quite well. I think Northumbria is a normal province, so there's no terrain advantages, and we're not crossing a river. So I think all's good. Oh, I can make a third army if I see that right. Where's the mercenary unit of the Scots? I don't know, to be honest. But it says the mercenary unit Scots is removed. But I don't see that I'm weak anyway. We did have to pay for this archer. We have 5. So we can pay by exactly those two. That's okay. I'm going to take the ones that can move. I first need to end this. I'm sorry. Now it's the naval movement. He'll just stay here and he'll just stay here. I'm okay with that. So, land movement. Now, I think what I want to do is I'm going to move all of these in here. Do I want to take him down here, this way? I think that's the way I want to go. And with him, I'm going to engage in Northumbria. I think with the Viking furore, we should be able to beat him. But he has the Huscarls, and I think they're heavy infantry, and you can see they basically hold up with our Berserks. Our Berserks is slightly better. He also has the same morale point. I think he's gonna get a tactical advantage, but I'm not going to spend that. I'm going to take the Viking Fuhrer, and I'm going to take the 6 feet of English land, because this is probably going to be the biggest battle I've fought in a while. So if we do win it, okay, we made one route. We killed one. Stop missing. We made one route and we killed him. Okay, that's big. I like that. He keeps missing. Yes, keep missing. Okay, and he killed one, but that's okay. We made two and one. Oh, okay. I think my archer is the weakest unit. This could be wrong because I don't know what SK means, but I'm going to pick him. So we made him rout. He lost a leader, but his king is safe. So there was a second leader in that stack. We've put him here. If I saw that correctly, he still has 3 units? I think he still has 3 units. Which is something we'll keep in mind. He can buy more, so we'll have to pay a bit of attention. The main thing is if he has 3 units, because he's a better leader than this guy. I will keep engaging him with this. In the next turn, I'm gonna engage him with this and move him into Northumbria, and we'll basically switch out the direction I went. He attacked me, even though he's completely outnumbered. Okay, so he's striking first, but I'm absolutely outnumbering him, and his units are crap. Because they can't beat my heavy units. So he made one route. They're all equal, so it doesn't matter who we make round. Now we get to attack. Okay, one hit, two hit. Yeah, they're all dead. So we're safe, yeah, he's safe, we're safe, everyone's safe. But he lost his entire army. And there's still one or two units there, we saw them be produced, but the army from before he lost. I think, keep in mind that I've put the AI at the hardest difficulty. I think that was not a particularly smart move. He just built another ship. I think he doesn't start with ships. Remember we've played him in the Let's Try. We started. I didn't see ships, so I'm going to think he didn't start. So he has one ship. So I should still be okay with having one ship here. I have favorable winds, so I could try to get this one down and outnumber him on this season, thereby completely keep him off this. But then I can't get reinforcements to the other side. So I don't think I want that. Let's get to the naval movement. No, let's hold on to that for when we really need it. I don't know how many units he has. I'm losing time for no reason if I'm attacking with him instead of him and he could beat him. But I think I want to be safe, so I'm going to... Oh, I can't attack because he fled into the woods. I'm one too much. So instead what I'll do is, I'm going to take this one unit and I'll move it into Suffolk. This way, he can send units this way up back into my land. I'm going to send him into Wales and him into Northumbria. This way he actually needs to beat us here. And he can do that, don't get me wrong, but he doesn't have a leader here. So right now he actually can't do it with these units. He needs a leader to be able to attack me, but he could use move into my land without a leader. So I'm a tiny, tiny, tiny bit I'm more secure now. We'll go like this. I think next turn I want to take them down because it's faster. Because if I disembark here and I move down, it's 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 steps to reach southern provinces, right? If I go here, I go 1, 2, and I can disembark in the same turn I moved, so I'm actually, I can reach Kent in 2 turns with units already on the ship. So I think I'm going to use the ship and go down and just save whatever I produce up here. He doesn't have units, but there were multiple units shown. Oh, it must be have been another leader. It must have been an additional leader. Wait. Harold, where are you running? Are you running in... Is this supposed to mean Ireland? No, right? This doesn't symbolize Ireland, right? This is just water. Are you running into water? I'm then literally out drown myself out of shame, something like this. I think this is probably a bug. Let's hope it's not a bad one. Let's hope we're not crashing in a bit or something because he's sending infantry into water. Actually, just leaders into water. And the Normans keep getting additional cards. That's my leader. Okay, these are my cards. Basically, my leader gets a little bit better, but his survival chance is lower. That's interesting. I'm going to make a quick cut here. It says a game takes only 1 hour, which turned 5 of 18, and I think I played for half an hour. But keep in mind that I'm probably playing slower because I'm talking a lot. So we'll see how long it takes in the end. I'm going to interrupt it here. I hope you enjoyed it so far. Please come and visit me on the second episode and do leave a like if you enjoyed this.